although we're fully remote and fully flexible business, we're also building in mental health days so that our team members can just take a mental health day. Mm-hmm. And we're also building in policies around IVF treatments and menopause and things like that. But I think for us, it's understanding how we can make it better for our team members as much as possible. And I think mental health days is quite a big one, because I think some days you just have one of those days where you just don't want to be at work. And it's almost allowing a team member to just have a day off without having a reason or a holiday day.
Can you share a little bit more about the parameters around those mental health days? Because I know some people who are hesitant to do that because they think people are just going to take any day off that they want if they've used up their holiday, for example. So although I'm very for that, I just wondered, what parameters did you put in place to make that work and make sure it's not abused?
We're starting to build these into our new working policies going forward. So they can have up to four or five mental health days a year. And for us, it doesn't matter if you have used your holiday and you're taking an extra day off. Sometimes you just burn out. Our job is very intense. We work really hard. We're always super busy. So if a mental health day is just a day to spend in bed, then fine. If we've got bigger challenges around mental health, that is a conversation we open with our team leaders. And then that's shared within the SLT to understand how we can better support. We've had team members that have taken sort of 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks sabbaticals if they need them because of the intensity of the role.